Hello, everybody. Welcome back to some more Resident Evil Zero. Let's go ahead and drop this again because it doesn't save, obviously. And I think we're gonna also need to drop this. And drop I think we'll be good. If not, actually I should probably quit that. One of the things about this game that I forgot to mention is that you actually run faster if you don't have anything equipped. I think you run a little bit faster with like the knives and the Molotovs, and you run a lot faster with nothing equipped. Yeah, throw it away. Anyway, we are Billy Cohen, wanted fugitive on a train. Let's take this map. Heck yeah, I'll take a map. Okay, and so this is one of the cool things. Because you can leave stuff, you can see where you dropped certain items. So, like, we know these two items are in that room with the save icon. It's pretty cool. Yeah, I'll flip a switch. Okay. So, there are those herbs there, and there's something else in here, but we don't need it clogging up our inventory before it's necessary. We'll wait until it's absolutely necessary. Crap. Well, wouldn't be Resident Evil without a giant something. Resident Evil 1 had the giant snake and giant shark. Resident Evil 2 had a giant alligator. Okay, so we're going to want to grab that ice pick. And let's go ahead and go in here. The only other room we can go into right now. Okay, yeah, so we want to grab this. And I actually want to grab this first aid spray, but then I'm going to drop it. And what that will do is, if I'm not mistaken, that will make it to where... Yeah, let me take that. And shotgun ammo. That will make it to where, when we exit the train, it'll be, like, there. That way, you know... We won't leave it behind. And I don't need that. And I don't have space for those ink ribbons anyway. Now you may be asking yourself, why isn't he equipping that shotgun? It's a perfectly good shotgun. I mean, double barrel. I mean, it's over under. It's pretty nice looking, ornate kind of. The reason for that is because I have played this train section enough to know that the knife is the best weapon for this upcoming fight. Which is hilarious. So, get over here. Scorpion. Nope, down. Shoot. Already messed it up. Man, I can't believe how bad it is. he's gonna kill me. Supposed to do is you're supposed to get up here right on him to where he can't do that little move and come on, I'm gonna end up needing to go back and get that. Well, I killed him. Hit you when he falls. Okay, well, I killed him. Well, let's leave that for now. And let's pick up this item here. That was real bad. That's not how you want to do it. So you can kill him with the knife you can kill him with the knife without taking any damage, but I totally screwed it up. Man, I almost want to redo that. Almost. I think I'm just going to use this first aid spray. Where is it? Come here. Use. Thank you. Oh, man. I feel real. Like, on my hard playthrough, I killed that boss with the knife without taking any damage. I feel so, like, I cannot believe that I ended up taking damage from that guy. It's because I choked. I was standing there and I should have just pressed, you know, down and started swinging, but what are you gonna do? So, I'm gonna go back to Rebecca, give her the ice pick. You know what I'm gonna... Oh, no, no, no. I don't want to be you right now. I'll go ahead and equip that. Or, you know what I should do? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop the shotgun here and pick up the handgun. I may even drop the shotgun shells. So let's drop. And then pick up. Nope, I didn't want to walk out. I wish there was like a search floor button that like just shows you everything you can pick up and you just select what you want to pick up and put down. Nope, I did it again. You can't see it, but I'm cringing right now at how poor this is going. Come on. Handgun? Yeah, handgun. You know, I'm gonna get out of the way of the door and drop those there. Okay, so let's go back outside. I need to remember to equip that pistol. And, let's see. Alright, go ahead and equip that. Run out here. I can't believe that. I mean, has that ever happened to you in real life? Bend down to pick something, accidentally walk out the door. Twice. Alright, so we took care of those zombies, thankfully. Hopefully they don't come back. I know on easy they don't come back, but on hard it seemed like they kept coming back after I killed them. So I just ended up running away from them more often than not. Switch to Rebecca. She's there. I wonder what Billy's doing. Oh, looks like I got a package. An ice pick. Yay! Just what I always wanted. I will take that ice pick. So let's check her inventory. So she has a green herb and the ice pick. Something sharp. I thought I would use it as a key and just like automatically do it, but apparently not. Hooray, we're out. Sweet. Hey, bro, you're on fire. Ah, I missed a perfect opportunity to say you're lit. Oh well. Okay, we'll use him. And we'll,
come on.
Okay.
Nope, nope. The buttons, man. Gotta remember what the buttons are. Did that really require. I mean, it looked like the handle was big enough you could pull it with your hand. I guess the leverage would. Oh. Rebecca, you suck. I'm gonna exchange with Billy. And then we're gonna get Billy to pick up the shotgun shells, the gasoline, and gonna have her pick up this, okay, as well as this. Yeah, I'll take the gold ring. Who knows what it's going to be for? I mean, it's Resident Evil. It's completely insane puzzles. So one thing you can do is, without switching, you can, like, be, like, control the other characters. Or the hook shot. Da-da-da-da. Hook shot operator's manual. This device should only be used when inspecting difficult to access roof cars or car roofs, or when connecting special trees. Return to its proper location after use. Whatever. Like, that's not important.
Follow me.
Yeah. Okay, so I think we want to be Billy. I think Billy's gun is slightly better than Rebecca's, and the door is now unlocked. Sweet. And we can run past this guy. Kidding me, Rebecca? Oh, and it's that weird. Alright, exchange with her that, then we'll let her use, and then maybe Billy. And the reason I went through all that, yes, is so I could get this empty bottle and make some Molotovs. Sweet. And we're gonna give Billy that as well. And then for now we're gonna be Rebecca. Let me go out here. Wow, I'm doing so bad. Like, and this is like easy mode. Well, not easy mode, but the next one up. I don't know. I think that once we get to the mansion,
you stay here.
Okay.
All right, you stay here, Billy. I'm gonna use my hook shot to go up on the roof. I love these transitions, these loading screens. They're so cool. Yeah, I'll jump down there. Hey, mister, what's up? Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, walk over here. Is that man dead? Yes. A jewelry box. Let's examine it. Looks like a case for holding jewelry. Open it. Yep. A silver ring. Would be super uncomfortable to wear. So if it's not jewelry, then what is it? Technically, I'm supposed to pick up that knife if I want an achievement. But I don't know about Steam achievements. I don't think it actually gives you anything in-game. That's the only reason I would pick it up, is if it gave me something in-game. Otherwise, I don't really care. Okay, so here we have, if we go this way, is there a clean herb? Give me that herb. Now let me get out of here before they start biting me. Because I think if I get out in time, they won't still be on me. Which I don't know how that works, but whatever. Okay, let's check our inventory. We are super duper...
Come on.
Okay.
We got too much crap on us. Did we get him? Rebecca, I swear. Okay, so what we want to do now is go I guess we can leave some stuff here. Let's leave this. We don't need it anymore. Let's leave this. Well, let's see. No. Let's give her. Hold on. Billy, where are you? Okay, so item management is going to be the thing. Let's give her all of that. I'm going to combine that. Let's give her that as well. And then I'll have him pick up the hook shot. And let me see the map. What did we leave anything anywhere? Yes, we left ammo. Okay. So have her go alone.
I'll go.
Yeah.
And she's gonna go to the conductor's room. Now, normally, like I said, there when I first came through here, there's a thing in here, but we didn't want it clogging our inventory. There's going to be a lot of that. Go to travel on the next whatever. I kind of wish I would have seen that screen for longer or paid attention. Anyway, so here it is, the briefcase. So we're going to combine the briefcase with these rings. And then we're going to examine it. Hey, it's been unlocked. Imagine that. Took the blue key card. So this is for the lead car. Okay, and we're gonna take these. Now one thing about this is it does lead to some crazy, like, oh, Rebecca is supposed to be like this super smart, even though she's like young, she's only like supposed to be like 19 or whatever, and she's on the Stars team because she's like a prodigy, like a you know, whatever. And so that's her like story. So that in game that translates to, oh, she can mix chemicals in Resident Evil 1. Like if you're playing Chris, he's too dumb to mix chemicals or whatever, so she has to do it. And here, she's the only one who can combine herbs. So Billy can't. He has to have her do it for him. So
let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go. Gonna have her pick up the, let's see, what's in here? Have her pick up the shotgun. Or the ammo. Either one. Give him all of that, and then we'll have her have just the gun itself. Okay. Yeah. And then, you know what? I don't think we're gonna stay. We're not gonna stay. We're just gonna keep on rolling. Keep this train a rolling, or actually, try to stop this train from rolling. But you know, it is what it is. So here's the electronic reader. Looks like the door will open if you have the right card. Well, we happen to have the right card. The door is now unlocked. You won't be needing this card anymore. Throw it away? Yes. Alright, time to go on through.
To the other side. This is Delta Team. We have gained control of the train. Over.
Understood.
This does not make any sense. How was the T-virus leaked? And why did it contaminate both the lab and the mansion, as well as a train almost 3 miles away?
That's irrelevant. We must make sure no knowledge of this gets out. Destroy the train. Completely. How far away are you from the nearest branch line?
About 10 minutes.
You know, he sounds like Agent 47. Oh, what happened? Well, sucks to be them. Also, weren't we right on the other side of that door? Or did that happen well before we got there? And it's just like showing us now. Train's kind of picking up speed. The engine chamber is badly damaged. There's no way to fix it. This is just a mess. Everything is just a mess.
The train will either derail or crash. I gotta stop this thing.
Okay. Brake operation manual. Use the brake control. Using the brake control. The following three steps are necessary to operate the brakes. Step 1. Activating the controls. The brake controls are located in the following locations. First car driver's compartment. Rear deck of the fifth car. To activate the system, you must insert a magnetic card into the vise in the fifth car. This will supply power to both sets of controls. Enter the rear deck code. Enter the code to the rear deck to release the lock. After this, the driver's compartment code can be entered. Enter the driver's compartment code. So the most convoluted emergency brake system in the history of emergency brake systems. Who will stay behind? Billy will.
I'll go over to the back deck and manipulate the control panel for the brake. You stay here and apply the brake when ready.
Okay. Rebecca!
Huh?
Don't screw up, okay?
I won't.
Okay, jerk. How about you don't screw up? Get another key card. Get the ammo. I think there's one more ammo. Yeah, more ammo. Oops. Okay. So the timer, we don't need to worry about the timer. We just need to go. Run as fast as we can. As if, for instance, we were a man made out of bread of ginger. Oh god. Okay. Didn't want to waste the ammo on him. That did. I wonder if he has any ammo on him. Alright, we actually probably should start worrying about this timer. Now that we're hurting and running low on ammo, we wasted 2 shotgun shells. Fixed camera angles sometimes mess with the whole movement, normal moving. Like, tank controls would actually make this a lot easier, I think. It just moves slower. So, like, there's a lot of instances where, like, I would want to dodge. Let's use this. So, I'm gonna get to 36.
is Rebecca. I have engaged the control device for the brake. Over.
Roger. I'll put the brake on now.
I'll put the brake on. No, you're going to enter a code and then put the brake on. 81. That was way harder for me than it should have been. As in, I was thinking about it too hard. So it didn't derail, but it sure did crash. Still alive. Well, it seems like Billy is at least.
Rebecca? Rebecca?
I'm here.
Apparently my arm is broken.
Are you all right? Hey, you managed to stop the train.
Yes. We managed.
We have to find a way out. I'll check it out.
Okay.
Let's regroup.
Okay.
Come on, Rebecca. Hurry up. So there's nothing in there that we need. So that means we don't have to fight those zombies. Even though she wasted good ammo. Alright, so. Let's. Let's combine that, and we'll use Rebecca because I find that it's easier to keep her alive if I am her. A lot of people go with Billy, and they just, like, get in between her, but I like to, I like to separate them. It seems to be easier to climb up, yes. So we're gonna go up here, find a save spot, and that'll be it for this episode. Hey, where have I seen this before? A mansion?
The Umbrella Research Center? The first general manager. Dr. James Marcus.
Who on earth are those people?
She's just a rookie, a member of STARS.
What about the male?
I'm unfamiliar with
him. Attention! Mm-hmm. This is Dr. Marcus. Please be silent as we reflect upon our company motto.
Okay.
Agents breeds discipline. Discipline breeds unity. Unity breeds power. Power is life.
Who are you?
It was I who scattered the T virus in the mansion. Needless to say, I contaminated the train too.
What?
revenge on Umbrella.
So this whole thread is so stupid. I feel like it bears saying each and every time it's brought up. Not the thread itself, like the idea of it is really actually pretty cool. It's just like the execution of
10 years ago, character. Dr. Marcus was murdered by Umbrella. You helped them, didn't you?
All right, well, here we are. This is where a large majority of the game takes place. Let me go ahead and leave that here. Let's see. I think there's a green herb around here somewhere that we don't have to use this one that I have in my inventory. Yeah, there's a green herb right here. No. No. Dang it, they just put her up to yellow caution. Okay, whatever. We'll leave that behind. Alright, and then let's see. Let's be him, and let's leave the hook shot right here. Let's leave these here. And let's leave some shotgun ammo at the base of the stairs. And we'll leave here at the top of the stairs. We'll leave that. Okay. So we've got our inventory sorted out. We want to have as much space as we can get. Let's have him pick up this handgun ammo. Let's see. Let's exchange. No, we want to make it pretty even. Yeah. And then we'll be, because she's in caution, we'll be her. That way we can, you know, whatever. Alright, so let's go ahead and pick up this ink ribbon and save. There's a typewriter. Record data? Sure will. The craziest thing happened to me today. I went on a train, and then it wrecked. Oh yeah, I met this guy named Billy. He likes to wear handcuffs. He's kind of a weirdo. Dear Diary. Anyway, guys, I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.